Dear viewers, welcome to our channel GVS Bank Academy. Today I am going to discuss about ECB for startups and trade credit. This is part 2. Yesterday I discussed ECB. Now today we are discussing about ECB for startups and trade credit. ECB for startup companies. External commercial borrowings for startup companies. This topic they are giving in CAB, BFM, 5 marks questions, theory based 5 marks case study. At least each and every examination they are asking this question, ECB, external commercial borrowing facility for startup companies. This is the now eligibility. An entity recognized as startup by the central government as on date of raising ECB. So as on date of borrowing the ECB, the unit must be recognized as part of a startup company. Startup. Normally, what is the definition for startup company means? Unit established up to, from the date of establishment up to 10 years, that can be treated as startup, number one. Number two, during the 1 to 10 years, any of the financial year, turnover not exceeding 100 crores. These are the two definitions given by the government for startups. So that is. So as on date of borrowing, the unit must be recognized as startup by central government. Now, what is the maturity period? Minimum average maturity borrowing period will be 3 years. The weighted average, the minimum average maturity will be 3 years of the ECB borrowing by startup. That is the minimum maturity. Recognized lender. From where the startup can borrow, that is the question. Members of FATF compliance countries. FATF means Financial Action Task Force compliance countries. Any of the country complying with FATF, Financial Action Task Force compliant country, from that the startup company can borrow. Forms. In what form the company can borrow ECB? In the form of loans. The company can borrow in the form of loans or non-convertible or optionally convertible or partly convertible preferences. So they can invest non-convertible preference, optional convertible or partly convertible preferences. They can issue. Currency. Which currency? Freely convertible currency or in INR. So the unit can borrow either in any of the freely convertible currency or in INR also, Indian rupees also. Amount per year limited to US dollar 3 million. Per year up to 3 years. Per year minimum 3 million they can borrow. The startup company per year it can borrow up to US dollar 3 million dollars. 3 million dollars it can borrow. This is the all-in cost as agreed between the borrower and the lender. So there is no ceiling, just like ECB and trade credit. In this case, it is as agreed between the borrowing company and the lender. End use, any expenditure in connection with the business of the startup company. So it is business related expenditure, any expenditure they can borrow. Conversion into equity. So even though these bonds, if they are issuing, that can be converted into later part of time in equity, that is also permitted in this. Security left to the borrowing entity. If the borrowing entity want to borrow without security, it can borrow. If the borrowing entity can give security, it is at the liberty of the borrowing startup company, that is there. Hedging. Now the startup company, if they want to borrow ECB, they are eligible to hedge, take a derivative. Hedging means risk mitigation derivative products. The startup company can go for any type of derivative products to hedge the foreign currency exchange risk through any of the permitted derivative products. As of today, almost all derivative products allowed. Forward contracts, futures, options, swaps, interest rates, interest rate futures, any of the product. As for the company's interest, they can hedge the foreign exchange risk through taking a derivative product. Conversion rate. at what rate the amount is going to be converted, that is at the market rate as on the date of agreement, whatever the agreement they are going for borrowing, that rate on that market rate on the date of agreement. So this is the simple 5 marks question they are asking for CIB BFM, Bank Financial Management. Several examination they had asked this question. So very simple question. There are two things, important things which you have to remember. Number one is minimum maturity period is 3 years. Number one. Number two, amount limited to $3 million $3 million per year. Number third one is on the date of borrowing, the unit must be recognized as startup by the central government. The three things are important. The remaining all are flexible. So this way, very easy question for getting 5 marks in BFM, Bank Financial Management Standard. Next sub point is trade credit. Trade credit is also for import of capital goods or raw material. This is called trade credit. What are forms of trade credit? Buyer's credit and supplier's credit. Trade credit consisting of two: buyer's credit and supplier's credit. Who are eligible to borrow trade credit in India? Person resident in India acting as importer, means importer and person resident in India, they can avail trade credit either in the form of buyer's credit or supplier's credit. Who are the recognized lenders? Supplier's credit. Supplier means supplier of the goods. Supplier of goods located outside India means indirectly you can say exporter. Supplier of goods means exporter located outside India. He can extend the finance under trade credit. That is called as supplier's credit. Buyer's credit. Buyer's credit. So buyer's credit means the banks, financial institutions, foreign equity holders located outside India. So Indian bank situated outside India, Indian financial institution situated outside India, foreign equity holders located outside India, and financial institutions and banks situated in International Financial Service Center, Gujarat, Gandhinagar. IFSC means International Financial Service Center, Gujarat, Gandhinagar. So these units can lend buyer's credit. So supplier credit means exporter itself arranging the credit. Buyer's credit means banks, financial institutions, foreign equity holders. Look, this is the recognized lenders. Amount under automatic route. Automatic route means without referring to RBI. That is called automatic route. How much they can borrow under automatic route? A, up to $150 million or equivalent. Amount for import transaction. Here important is for import transaction. For oil, gas refining and marketing companies, airline companies and shipping companies, they can borrow under automatic route under trade credit for a transaction is up to 150 million or equivalent. For others, other than oil, gas, marketing and airline and shipping companies, up to 50 million or equivalent for import transactions. So others, up to 50 million or equivalent for import transaction, they are allowed to borrow under trade credit. The period of trade credit, calculated from the date of shipment. The period of trade credit calculated from the date of shipment shall be up to 3 years for import of capital goods. From the date of shipment, 3 years for import of capital goods. If it is going to cross 3 years, that is called as ECB. That's why you have to note it very carefully. ECB maximum up to 3 years only. For shipyards, shipbuilders, the period of trade credit for import of non-capital goods also 3 years. For shipyards companies, shipbuilder companies, the period of trade credit for import of non-capital goods also 3 years. These are the capital incentive units. That's why they are given 3 years. For non-capital goods means we can say import of raw material, that is called other non-capital goods means import of raw material in nature. The period will be up to 1 year or one operating cycle, whichever is less. So for other than non-capital goods means for import of raw material, example, the period will be 1 year or one operating cycle, whichever is less. Operating cycle means this is one working capital cycle. Conversion of cash into raw material into semi-finished goods, semi-finished goods into finished goods into credit sales, again credit sale to cash sales. That is called working capital cycle. So one operating cycle, maximum 1 year, whichever is less, that is the period of trade credit. All in cost ceiling per annum. What is the cost of borrowing? All in cost ceiling means sometimes they are asking AIC, all in cost ceiling. Benchmark, any other benchmark rate, LIBOR or any other benchmark rate plus 250 basis points. Any other external benchmark lending rate plus 250 basis point spread means benchmark rate plus 250 basis points above that benchmark, that is all. In the examination, they are asking very frequently this question. Exchange rate. What exchange rate foreign currency denominated trade credit? Exchange rate prevailing on the date of agreement. Exchange rate prevailing on the date of agreement. Or INR denominated trade credit. The exchange rate shall be the rate prevailing on the date of settlement. On the date of settlement funds, settlement date. This is the exchange rate for a trade credit. The most important point is all-in cost ceiling number one, trade credit period number two, and amount is number three. Next 8 point, change of currency of borrowing. Now, after borrowing, the borrower is allowed to change the currency. Yes, it is permitted. From one freely convertible foreign currency to another freely foreign currency, or from foreign currencies to INR is also permitted. For example, party has borrowed in one currency earlier. Now they want to change its currency, that is allowed. From foreign currency borrowing to INR is also freely permitted. Then hedging provision. Hedging provision. So for mitigating the exchange risk, the borrowing organization, they have to go for suitable derivative products to hedge the risk. The entities raising trade credit are required to follow the guidelines for hedging. What are the guidelines issued by RBI from time to time? They have to follow that, if any. Issued by the concerned sectoral or prudential regulator in respect of foreign currency exposure. Such entities shall have a board approved risk management policy. Any company is borrowing the trade credit for the foreign exchange risk management, there must be some board approved policy for the risk management. So these are the trade credit. Very simple two topics are there. Both are important for various promotional examinations and also for CIAB BFM examination. Thank you very much for all the participants for watching our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for all.